Tell me when you're starting. Hello, welcome to Cafe Disco. I'm gonna turn this off. I don't wanna give my fans seizures. Got five fans, five subscribers, you know? And I respect you guys. I don't wanna fuck you guys up. I'm Zach, this is Luke.
Hey.
Today the video is we're gonna make some coffee. I'm gonna teach him how to do it. I'm a seasoned professional and he just wants to learn. So that's what the video is today. So the machine I got on Kijiji, which if you're watching from the States, that's like Craigslist. But in Canada, it's a pretty nice machine. It's a heat exchanger. It, I think, retails for like $3,000. I paid $1,400 for it. It's 13 years old. This water spout doesn't work. But other than that, I've been pretty happy with the machine. Obviously, every machine you kind of have, you have to like learn the tricks and stuff of it. And that was definitely a process at first. I didn't even know how to plumb it in, which it's not the prettiest thing in the world. But you know, sometimes you got to do that. It's worth it for the good coffee every morning. Okay, so I'm gonna teach you how to make coffee.
Stoked.
Step one, remove the portafilter, obviously, mm-hmm. And you have to make sure it's dry. Gotta make sure it's hot too.
Yeah, I know. We tried this already, yeah.
I made him a coffee before, but you have to have a pre-coffee before we have the coffee, obviously. Yeah. And I went like that and he flipped out.
Because it's hotter than you think.
Okay, so that's good. We're gonna put that in here. We're gonna weigh out the coffee. A lot of people ask me why we weigh out the coffee, and it's just a way to keep everything precise and make sure the coffee is repeatable, right? Because if I have a golden shot, like the best shot I've ever had, I want to make it again tomorrow. I don't want it to be luck, right? So
you keep track, eh? Like you got this thing.
Well, I do keep track a bit, but mostly it's not
there.
There's a little board, but that's honestly, I use that mostly for pour over because I do have a pour over set up here as well, you can see. But sometimes the notches on that grinder, I don't make it as frequently, so I kind of have to remember, and that's just a visual guide. This one, I try to keep the grinder always dialed in. It's never a full process as a home barista, because I'm not gonna make five shots in the morning, three shots in the morning, make sure it's perfect. So every day I just make it a little bit more dialed in. So I kind of remember, and it's supposed to be like kept dialed in. So if I have a shot and I'm tasting that it's too bitter, that's when I'll adjust it a bit for tomorrow, and then hopefully that one's good. And then if it's still too bitter, then I'll adjust it again. So 18 grams, that's what I start at for the dry dose. And then I want to pull 36 grams out. That's always my starting point. You know, I think that's just, it's proven to work. You know, a lot of people say you could get like 18.5 grams or 19. Or less, but I only mess with that when it's a weird shot. So I got the Brazze Sette here, which is a lovely grinder. I love it, zero retention. I find that it still retains a little bit of the grounds in between the grind or the burrs, but it's better than most. I actually find that right now that I have to hold these two things here. If you look closely, these are how you adjust the grind settings. So there's just a lot of vibrations because it's moving really quickly. So I hold it together so it doesn't grind, so it doesn't move. So 7 seconds, you can look at the grounds here. It's really fluffy. It's kind of a little bit in like a mound, which I don't know, some people on YouTube or whatever, they say that's a bad thing. I don't know if it is. You can watch this. So I used to have a distributor tool, but I don't really do that anymore. Luke, are you paying attention? I realize I'm talking to the camera,
I'm
but
paying
I should be talking to you really. So instead of using distributor tool, I just use my finger. So I go like that, and just trying to make sure that it's flat as can be. And then what I do is that looks pretty flat, but what I do is I tap this. And honestly, that's pretty flat. You know, you don't really need the fancy tools. Yeah, it's great. I had one, I got it like, really cheap, but
this guy always gets the deals, you know.
Yeah, I was gonna make a Jewish joke, but not on YouTube, so I guess I won't. Okay, so I'm Jewish, but I guess it doesn't matter. Okay, so right now I flush it. It's a heat exchanger, so you just keep things fresh. You don't want it to be over hot. And what I do like about that too, I usually do it for 3-4 seconds. The light's gonna turn on, so then I usually pull the shot right when the light turns off. So we know that's gonna happen. What do we want to drink? You want a latte or do we want
just want? Espresso? I think I just want an espresso. Yeah.
That's probably best because we can taste the coffee and we can decide if we want to dial it in a little bit differently. Honestly, every time it's super annoying, the light hasn't gone off, right? So I always plug it in, get ready to go. And right when I plug it in, the light turns on. It's annoying. I mean, we're not gonna wait all day, so we're just gonna go for it. Every time, I swear, every time.
That's okay, right?
Well, it means it's not fully the perfect temperature, I usually wait a second and it only takes like 4 seconds. So I'm gonna hit it. It's never really, I've noticed the problem of being under temperature. See, it's perfect. I have an automatic shot timer here. We're aiming for, I think, about 28 seconds. You make sure you get that shot, that's beautiful. It's coffee pouring, I think. See that? So I weighed the yield. Oh, this is going fast. Okay, this is why we're gonna make a few. So it's 22 seconds, I was aiming for 27. So I'm gonna adjust the grind to make it tighter. So I'm moving it a little bit more than one whole notch on the grinder. And honestly, that's probably because the last time I made a coffee, there were two bodies in this tiny apartment, and now there's four. So that, like, the humidity, 100%, that always has an effect.
Interesting.
But that's fine. It's obviously not ideal, so I just go like this after, kind of clean it. It's a dual purpose, save water. We're in British Columbia, Canada, most beautiful place in the world, so we've got to conserve water.
I'll tell you about it.
So this will be an interesting experiment too. We're gonna taste this, and it pulled really quick.
That means it shouldn't be as bitter, right?
Shouldn't be as bitter, but it might be too acidic because it's a spectrum.
It's good.
Nice. Dan, you want to try?
Love to.
After
this
that, nobody else is trying
because
Dan's sick
of
the dog.
Oh, true. Are you sick?
Cheers, I'm sick. I'm not going to do it. It's okay. I can wait until I have my own cup.
Let me take another one. Oh, okay, yeah. What a nice guy. It's quite good.
Well, it's, I don't know, it might be this coffee. But
I like this one more than the one you made me earlier this morning. So I guess I like them a little more acidic than bitter, no?
Yeah. I do too, but this to me, like, it's not sweet acidity, which is what I kind of look for in a coffee.
So that's the coffee rather than...
So it's not bad. It's definitely not bad. It's definitely smooth and not bitter at all.
No, you go for it.
We're going to make another one, but it's not sweet. And that's what I kind of want. Like, I want a balance shot. I don't want, but it's not bad. You're right. So I adjusted it one whole thing.
Right.
Maybe I'll adjust a little bit further back, so it'll probably be around 25 seconds. And you know, with a little milk, that would be amazing. Because if you want a little bit on the strong acidic side,
I'm doing this one.
Okay, you want to do
it?
Oh yeah, I'm gonna do it. Okay. So what are the rules of this game? Am I allowed to help you, coach you, or no?
I think I looked at Dan first.
Sorry?
I've talked to Dan before too.
Maybe not.
You know what?
We gotta give a shout out to the Beach Boys' Pet Sounds.
Yeah, unbelievable.
Second rated album, according to Rolling Stones magazine. And you know that's fact.
This guy, right?
Yep.
Strong start here.
Very strong start. So far, killing it. 18, so, eh?
Luke likes coffee. He generally.
I do really like coffee, yeah.
He makes a moka pot, I think, every morning.
I do.
You have a grinder?
Yep.
He's a blade grinder. Which is,
I'm more a quantity coffee kind of guy. Because I'm addicted to it.
Yeah.
Oh, shit. I put way too much
in. It's okay.
Yeah. No.
Just use the same scoop. Okay, it's fine. I'm not a backseat driver. I'll let him do his thing.
Feels like you are. 18.1.
That's fine. 18. I usually aim for 18.1.
Must have been that humidity.
Just to account for that little bit of retention that's in it. Good thing about both these machines, unless you're doing something like really stupid, you can't really break them. So so that's why I'm not freaking out right now.
You press go?
Yeah.
Play means
go. You gotta hold it. You gotta hold the...
I hold the bottom too.
All right. Thanks, Dan. See?
I got you, buddy.
Oh.
Just...
Ah!
I was wrong. You can't fuck it up. So the coffee we're making today is Palette. It's roasted in Vancouver. It's pretty good. This is a Burundi. It says it tastes like juicy orange soda, pomegranate, sugar cane, and syrupy body.
It's pretty fluff though, no? Come on.
It's pretty good.
All right.
That is kind of what we were tasting in that shot. Definitely a very syrupy body. A little bit of that bitter kind of citrus, which is kind of my problem with it. What I was saying was like, I want something that generally more sweet.
So how many PSI is on this bad boy?
So you want 15 pounds of pressure, that's what they say.
No way, really?
Yes.
Oh shit.
But they say it's all about consistency.
Right.
Right, so what you want to do, I didn't really teach you this,
is
that you want to put one finger here and one finger on this side, and you want to come down as like straight as possible. You see how my wrist?
You don't want to get that tennis elbow.
Yeah, you don't want to go like this, you don't want to do anything like that. You just kind of want to do one motion, and then you kind of twist at the end a little bit just to polish it. You don't really have to focus on that.
Right.
But once I feel the compression,
mm-hmm.
I kind of stop. Like, I don't try to kill this.
Right.
And you know, like, my brothers, I taught them how to make coffee too. I think you need more than that. That didn't seem like a lot, but
Strong.
Okay. You don't really want to, this is a good lesson. You don't really want to push and turn at the same time.
Oh.
You actually want to push and then polish at the end.
And do you? I definitely push and turn.
That's fine. We'll see what happens. That's why we're doing this video.
Do you lighten up the pressure when you polish?
Yeah, it shouldn't be a pressurized polish. So you want to make sure I want it to be more than half. This machine, you kind of have to do that, else it leaks. I don't know why. Hmm. They said I could get a little extra spacer. Usually I'll polish it.
I mean, don't let me do this.
This guy. Shout out to Arcade Fire playing right now.
I love
Canadian content.
Who the fuck is Arcade Fire? Remember that whole controversy? Alright.
Okay, hit the middle button.
Middle button.
Yeah. So I'm guessing it's going to be around the same because it was a... Well, maybe not because your tamp was actually... You double tamped, which usually slows things down.
Your husk can get in there.
Yeah. So yeah, it might be around 29 seconds, I'd say.
Yeah, it looks kind of darker.
Get in the cup. Gotta get right in the cup there, Husky.
He's not a backseat driver, though.
Oh, yeah. Oh, that's the money shot.
Okay, the time's at 22, so now we're past.
But you do it by the weight, so I stop it when it gets to 32.
Oh, so we're way long.
Nope, we're not. Stop it.
Perfect. Oh, I went a little bit over.
So 30 seconds.
Oh, I went way over.
No, that's fine. 37, that's perfect.
Oh, really?
That's very precise.
Oh, yeah. I'm an engineer. Pretty
on it. Okay, so that's interesting. So it ran for 30 seconds. The last one was 22. We're going to taste it.
Mm-hmm.
And obviously it ran longer, so it's going to be a little bit more bitter.
It is more bitter. Oh, it didn't slurp. Yeah, you got to slurp, eh?
Honestly, I think this is a little better, though. Maybe I need some water, though.
Yeah, we didn't really do a palate cleanser. What's her name? We didn't...
Gale.
Shout out to Gale, Seattle Coffee Gear.
Yeah,
Seattle's
just down south. It's pretty good, yeah. No, I think I like the first one better, though.
I don't know, this one has a way better after kind of taste.
Which to me, that's the other one.
It's a very crispy, like, citrus. I don't know, like I want to say it's almost like nectarine-ish.
Mm.
But maybe because it is still pretty bitter, that it like...
I actually like that much more.
Yeah.
I like that much more. Yeah, you can definitely taste... I feel the flavors more, like the citrusy, more
that after
than
taste
the...
Six.
Yeah, it's quite nice.
Yeah, that one was a little...
So you're going to keep... You're
going
to hold on
to
that one then.
We're going to hold on to this one.
Right.
Yeah. Do you want
to
back?
No, it's just kidding. I think that's it. No?
Yeah, we can make more, but we don't want to make this video too long.
Yeah,
so
people already stopped watching a while.
Yeah, for sure. What was that, Husky?
Just saying.
Yeah, he was trying to...
Remember to like and subscribe.
Oh, yeah, like and subscribe, for sure. Yeah. No, don't bother. You can if you want, but you'll get a video every year. Once a year. If you want one coffee video once a year, then you can like and subscribe.
Unbelievable.
Husky, that's a really nice shirt. Where'd you get that?